Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. I cannot believe that we are already on our last prompt. The challenge has gone super quick, isn't it? We started our challenge with a beautiful sunset and then we progressed into a galaxy sky and then we went on to painting a moonscape. And then mountains, and now here we are on our last prompt, which is Northern Lights. I hope you are having fun with this challenge. You still have few more days to go to complete all the prompts for the challenge and post it on your Instagram stories. Let's get started with our project. So the very first thing is the brushes. These are quite a few brushes that I absolutely love working with. All these materials that I am using here will be mentioned in the description box below. So go do check it out. And the very first thing that we will be doing is applying a coat of water on our paper, because we will be going ahead and doing the sky completely with wet on wet technique. So I'll be just listing down the colors that I'll be using here. If you have so noticed in photographs, you would have also seen that Northern Lights is a very colorful and bright looking sky. The most common colors that you get to see in a photograph for Northern Lights is the blue and the mixture of blue, yellow and the greens. So I thought let's try out some uncommon colors today and see how it goes. So I'm here going ahead with shades of purple and violet, little bit of quinacridone rose and yellow green or sap green. So just keep watching. It's a fairly very easy project. There is nothing much complicacy, just that you need your paper to be wet for you to carry out the strokes and to layer the colors on the paper so that the colors can blend with each other to create the stunning looking effects. In order to have that glowing effect on the sky, we will be lifting out some of the colors that we had just laid, especially the lighter color, so that it gives more realistic, and that glow and the burst of colors, it becomes more pronounced and prominent in the painting. Now while you are doing the streaks of light, make sure that you go very light-handedly. Your wrist should be very flexible. You should not be applying too much of pressure while doing this strokes, because that would lift out your background colors. So you would not want that. So go little smooth and easy on the paper. Now it's a time to add some stars. For splattering the stars, I'm here using white gouache. You could go ahead and use white acrylics or white poster color or any other white watercolor paint would also do. But just that watercolor paint you have to go multiple layers of splattering. Now I'm going ahead and adding some pines. So this pines I am adding at an angle. It is not the straight pines that we are doing. So adding at an angle will give a different outlook to the painting overall. So it's a very easy painting, right? I hope you are able to follow me along. And these pines are fairly easy. You just need to drag your brush in a staggered movement. And always remember, the pines are like inverted cones. So your tip should be narrower and your bottom or base of the pines is broader. So it would be like an inverted triangle, you could say. Here I'm going ahead and adding pines of various shapes and sizes. Make sure that you vary the length and size of these pines, because if you do very symmetrical and same size of the pines, it will not give that appealing look to the painting, and also it will look kind of weird, isn't it? Because in nature, when you see a forest or a pine groups, it is always in different shapes and sizes. So I'm going ahead and filling that with this black. You could use black or Payne's gray color. So we are done with our painting, and now it's time to peel out our masking tape. Always do it at an angle. I have been stressing this in all my videos, so I hope you get that. So here it is with that coat. It's looking so pretty, isn't it? I'm loving it. I hope you are loving the challenge so far and have enjoyed painting with us all these beautiful prompts that we have demonstrated in our respective channels. You still have time till 28th. We are hoping to see some great projects. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.